Hey, hello everyone, and welcome to Midday Cabaret Cast Edition. My name is Dan Murphy. I'm the managing director here at the Broadway Rose. We want to thank Pearson Financial, who is our season sponsor and has been a sponsor with us for, gosh, about the past 25 years or so. So we thank Conrad Pearson, Bonnie Conger, and everybody over at Pearson Financial for their many, many, many years of support. We are coming to you live from the Broadway Rose New Stage right here in the wishy-washy Washateria. And we're here to talk about Honky Tonk Laundry, our current show playing now through February 20th. We're going to be talking to the two stars, Jessica Brandis and Emily Cadiz. And I want you to remember that if there's some burning question you may have, you're going to go ahead and submit it in the Facebook or the YouTube, and we will go ahead and get to a few of them during the broadcast. So with that said, let's go and meet Jessica and Emily. So good afternoon, ladies. Thank you for being here. Yeah. How are you doing? Recovered from opening weekend?
Yep, we've had two solid days off so far. Okay. So it has been basically like a month.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's been great.
Well, thank you for coming in on that third, potentially third day off,
yeah,
which didn't work out because you're here. So you opened last Thursday. So how did that feel to finally do it in front of an audience?
Oh, great. I loved it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good. Good.
I mean, it was a long time coming, it felt like.
Uh-huh. All of our like production team is so bored of the show by that point. that it's so great to have new people have some sort of response to what we're doing.
Sick of Sharon saying, applause, applause, applause.
Yeah, and move on. There will be applause.
Move I on. Forgot that there were funny bits. And right. I was like, oh yeah, that's right. Thanks, guys.
Right. Great. So the response has been great to this. I mean, I know that from the lobby, but you must feel coming from the audience, which is great.
It definitely has seemed like our audience has been really involved so far. Mm-hmm. So things that we didn't expect, like clap-alongs and things that are coming out of nowhere, which is really fun. So, you know, someone is obviously starting that in the audience, and then mm-hmm. it's catching steam, and people yeah. are committed. So that's a really... it's a cool experience when you have yeah. such a group of strangers get it all together at once to do something like that. So I think people have been liking it.
Yeah, I do try to remind them in the curtain speech that it's not a sing-along.
Well, thank you.
Well, it's clearly a clap-along.
And, right.
And what I really appreciate about them is that they are not like trying to make it faster with their clapping. They just clap
right.
along.
They can keep a beat.
I am so proud of them.
Hilarious. Give us the quick synopsis, Emily, of the show. What is it about, Honky Tonk Laundry?
I think it's a come-of-age story of, I don't want to say middle-aged woman, but I think it's a little bit of a come.
You're both much too young.
Okay. But from my perspective, that would be what the musical is about, is that this woman is stepping into her own as a woman who grew up with some very, you know, probably some very traditional ideas of what a woman in the South would do. Mm-hmm. And I relate to that, and I love that part of the story. So it's also just ridiculously funny and silly and filled with all sorts of music that I grew up listening to. So,
right.
I mean, that's also what the play is yeah. about.
Yeah. Yeah. How about the, we're here in the wishy-washy Washateria, so we want to give a shout-out to both Sean O'Skay and James Sheringhausen,
mm-hmm.
who... Yeah. How is it doing with your character? You own the wishy-washy Washateria.
I do.
How about doing all that laundry mm-hmm. as you're having to say, I mean, is it like
no.
trying to do 12 things at the same time?
No, I'm a single mom of three daughters. It's like basically singing in my
okay.
living room.
Excellent.
I'm like, oh, more socks. Oh,
right.
more underwear.
Right. Now, this is your first time performing here at the mm-hmm. Broadway Rose, and this has been such a funky last 2 years, but the good news is Sharon keeps pretty good records mm-hmm. of everybody that's come through the door. So you were kind of a no-brainer when she went through the files and said, I gotta call in Emily. She'd be perfect for this.
It came out of the blue.
Yeah.
I think a lot of people, that used to try to perform or were performing, mm-hmm. Kind of just put a pause on that for a while. Yeah. And so this was unexpected for sure. And I'm so appreciative that she did this and then did this.
Yeah. And was country western, that's not quite your forte, your opera?
Well, I've done a little bit. Yeah, I would say the last 4 years I've studied primarily classical music. And that has been, but I think everyone sings along to these songs in the car.
Yeah.
It's hard not to.
Yeah.
And I distinctly remember her asking me, she goes, did you, have you ever heard of Patsy Cline? In the audition. And I was like, I grew up in Cresswell. There were like 1,500 people in a farm in front of our high school that we all had to participate in. Yeah, that's kind of like our anthem. All of her songs were just anthems.
So. Now, Jessica, this is your second time here with the Broadway Rose.
Yeah.
And of course, it could have been your third had COVID not hit, because she was cast in The Wedding Singer.
It was.
And but when that went away, again, and that's where we first met you, I think, was during the auditions during that period. So when
do you want to hear a funny story that I've never told you?
Okay.
Okay. So I actually auditioned once 10 years ago.
You did?
I did, but I came to a dance call because I had just moved to Portland and I missed the vocal call.
Did you crash it?
Yeah, I showed up. Yeah. And then in my mind I was like, well, how hard can a dance call in Portland be? So, and it turned out it was harder than I wasn't ready for that. And so I got cut without being asked to sing, which I was like, okay, goodbye. And so I just walked away. But yeah, so isn't that funny?
Do you remember the show? Were we doing a chorus line maybe?
Oh, God,
something?
I have no idea what the season was. It was like the season, but I don't know. I don't know.
Hilarious.
It had to have been in like 2009, 2010. Okay. Isn't that funny?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
We keep, Sharon keeps good files.
Okay,
and we have to go back and find out what the notes were.
Terrible. Why did she think she was a dancer? Because I'm a singer. Okay.
Wow.
I don't even put dance on my resume. I just put she can move, kind of.
So we've got you here for Analog and Vinyl, which was great.
Yeah.
Which is a really, really fun show. And that's when our audiences were kind of half here, half masked. Some vaccinated, some, and then before everything shut down again in August. So that for us was great to have somebody in the audience to do it for.
Yeah. It was a really fun production to do. It was my first time here with all of you. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, everything was different for your entire team, but I was like, oh no, it's my first rodeo, let's go. So things felt sort of normal. Oh, and of course, you're building one under construction at the same time, so it was like a super a convergence of events for
yes,
sure.
Yes. Yeah. Here's a little dressing table behind the set.
Exactly.
Be quiet, the audience is coming in.
You know. And it's summer. Here's a box fan as well.
Right.
So hot.
Oh, yeah.
That was great.
Barbie size.
So we're hoping that you will go ahead and sing a song for us from the show.
Oh, sure. Okay,
All
yeah.
Right.
We'll sing a song.
Great. Okay. So now Jessica is going to sing Why'd You Come In Here Looking Like That? And that's Words and Music by Robert Carlyle and Randy Thomas. And it was first recorded by Dolly Parton back in 1989. So hit it.
Why'd you come in here looking like that? In your cowboy boots and your painted on jeans. All checked out like a cowgirl's dream. Waltzing right in here looking like that. There goes my baby, dragging my heart behind. He's driving me crazy. Who says love is blind? He's got a wandering eye and a traveling mind. Big ideas and a little behind. Out with a different woman every night. And now he's dancing on this heart of cowgirl's dream. waltzing right in here looking like that. Why'd you come in here looking like that? When you could stop traffic in a gunny sack. Why, you almost giving me a heart attack. When you waltz right in here looking like that. Why'd you come in here looking like that? Why'd you come in here? Oh, looking like that!
Yay. That's great. How great. You know, and that was just one of 23 songs that are sung in Honky Tonk Laundry that's playing here at the Broadway Rose New Stage now through February 20th. So we're going to take a time now to figure out a question that somebody would have submitted. So let's see what inquiring minds. Tyrene Batta, I have a question for both actors. If you were to walk into the wishy-washy to drop off a load of laundry, what advice would you give your character and what song would you sing to them?
Okay. What advice? It's a two-parter.
It's a two-parter. Okay. The advice and what would you sing to them, which I maybe will enhance that advice.
Oh, man. Okay, I have the advice down, but now I got to think of a song.
Okay.
I think my advice and my song might be the same thing.
Okay.
Maybe.
Okay, say it out loud.
Well, I'd probably just be like, run. And I'd probably sing her the Dixie Chick song, Ready to Run.
Okay, so for Katie, I'd probably give the advice of like, girl, you got this. You don't need no man to bolster yourself. And then I would probably give her that Sheryl Crow song, you know, that don't impress me much. Because we don't need to be impressed by cars that are all one color. That's not a thing.
No. Anymore.
No. Yeah. Interesting question. Cool.
Okay. All right. Thank you, Tyrene.
Yeah.
So we have a very quick rehearsal period here at the Broadway Rose. And especially when there's two people. So chances are, if you're on stage, the other one's not, and you barely leave the stage during this whole show. How was that rehearsal process? I mean, you had the scripts and scores ahead of time, but then boom.
Thank God.
You know, I haven't done a full musical, I mean, you know, full transparency, in 20-some years. So this has been kind of like baptism by fire. And I don't think there's any there's no other way to do it, right? If you're going to do something, just jump in and do it. And then you learn everything as you're doing it, and you adjust. And I think
not everyone does a two-person show.
No, they don't.
Their baptism by fire. Okay. No,
the lots of fire and brimstone. So yeah, it's definitely been it's the way you do it here, and the fact that it was a two-person show combined with the large break has been just been an event.
It's been an event.
but it, like, I will not be able to appreciate it as much until I think after.
You do the show, and they go, God, this rehearsal period is so long.
Yeah. Wow. I just want to be present, like, in it right now and just give it my all, and then I will reflect on all of that afterwards.
We look forward to the email.
Dear Dan.
How about you, Jessica? You like this kind of truncated?
I do. Mm-hmm. I love it when it's just like, get it together. You know why? I think it keeps... sometimes a show can get very stale if it's very, very overworked. Like anything, like a sourdough, right? If you overknead it, it sort of doesn't rise. So I think there's something really special special and terrifying to go into opening night like, I don't know, let's hope it all comes together. Because we are like making edits and changes up until that very evening. Mm-hmm. And sometimes even 5 minutes before we go on. So there's definitely a spontaneity that's involved, but I think that it really does keep the show and the way it blossoms over the course of the run. Mm-hmm. I think it keeps it really interesting and fresh, and I really love to see that growth over the course of the run. And it's something that you just can't have unless you have a live audience. And so I'm always so grateful to everyone who comes. You know, because we are following all of the safety protocols. Emily and I are in a bubble of people because we're the only unmasked individuals every night in the show. So, you know, it's just been really fun. I love it. I love the speed. It's great.
Yeah. what she said.
And scary.
What she
what
said.
She said.
And scary.
Great and scary.
Yeah.
So in the show, in the second act, which the audience tends to go a little crazy, you all yodel. So
yep,
now,
too.
Did you, and yodeling's hard. Like, I think people think they can yodel, you know, and it's ridiculous.
That
did you all yodel?
Really good. Do
before?
That again.
Yeah. Oh, my God. There's a reason I'm not in the show, for many reasons. You can call me Earl or Danny. How about yodeling? Had you ever done it before? Or when you read the script, you were like, wait, we have to yodel? What's that about?
I mean, I've done Sound of Music 2 or 3 times. So I have definitely
so
sung.
Like, so
I've
all
sung,
that yodeling?
Well, no, I've sung Goat Herd, right, where there's like a little bit of yodeling
okay.
in Goat Herd, okay? But not at this level, and certainly I've not entered into any private yodeling competition. So not ever been a thing in my life. And in the script, I didn't really notice it, but there's a cast album, so listening to the recording, I was like, oh, no, that goes on for a bit. So it wasn't sort of like... In Sound of Music, it's relatively mixed in, so you can kind of
right.
get away with it. I was
yeah.
like, no, you can't get away with this. You have to
yeah.
you have to actually yodel. So it took some effort on my part, for sure.
How
I,
about
did,
you?
I don't know.
I think it was hilarious because we were standing next to each other in the audition.
This was like a cold reading of yodeling, by the way. Which,
cold
which
yodeling.
I don't know if that's... Cold yodeling is not for everyone, I'll say.
And I just remember Jeff coming out and saying... Oh, you're gonna yodel, cold yodel, and both of us were just like,
no,
no, that's not right.
Yeah.
And we get in there.
They just like throw that at people.
And I feel like I'm back in like some like sight reading. I was going t t ta t t t t ta t t t ta. Nope, t t ta t. And we got through it, and that was fine. And now we
channeled the Swiss Miss.
Channeled the Swiss Miss with a little mini marshmallow.
I mean, now we yodel like champions.
Champions.
Like, now it's fine.
Champions.
Champions. Yep. She has the harder yodeling part by miles and miles.
It's just faster. It's a lot faster.
Hilarious.
Oh, yes, it is.
Very fun.
So
it's
yeah.
really fun. We look forward to it. Well, at least I do. I look forward to it every night because I know that I'm like from here on out, smooth sailing. We're
yep.
done. The show's
mm-hmm.
over, basically.
We pass the yodel part.
Exactly.
I know. And
we're through
it really is like that song that allows for the forgiveness of multitudes of sins that have happened prior to.
Well, they may have screwed up, but
yeah.
not yodeling.
I know. They're just like, whoo, that did it. We're done. Out here. Yep. So I lean heavy on the yodel now.
Well, Emily, we're not going to ask you to yodel, but
no,
would
God.
You sing a song?
Oh, yes.
Sans yodeling.
Yeah.
Excellent. So with that, this song that Emily is going to sing right now is one of country music's most iconic songs, Stand By Your Man, with words and music by Billy Sherrill. Nobody remembers that. They remember Tammy Wynette, who also wrote the song. So take it away, Emily.
Sometimes it's hard to be a woman, giving all your love to just one man. You'll have bad times, he'll have good times, doing things that you don't understand. But if you love him, you'll forgive him. Even though he's hard to understand. And if you love him, oh, be proud of him. 'Cause after all, he's just a man. And
great. That was great. And that song, of course, was made famous by the legendary Tammy Wynette. And this production has many more of country music's leading ladies, like Loretta Lynn, Patsy Cline, Carrie Underwood, Trisha Yearwood, Reba McEntire, and many, many, many more. So here's a question. Were you a country music fan before the show, other than what you may have noticed singing in your car?
Yes.
That's okay.
You're forgiven.
I feel like, you know, I come from the world of classical music, so sometimes it's you know, looked down upon. But I actually love it, and I think one of my favorite artists right now is Chris Stapleton. So,
okay.
I mean, I just love him. Love him. Yeah. And Lady Antebellum and a few others that I won't go. Okay, I won't go down that path. But yes, I do.
Excellent. Jessica?
I wouldn't say that I'm a fan. I think, like any really large genre of music, there's stuff that I think is really great to listen to and stuff that I'm like, oh, I could pass for sure. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, there's obviously country songs that I would be like, oh, no thanks. But in sort of working towards this show, I started listening more. And you know what? It is, man, we don't give country artists enough credit. It is deceptively hard. Mm-hmm. Country music is deceptively difficult.
Yeah.
And so it's been really fun to explore it and kind of understand it in a new way. It sounds easy. It's not,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah. Do you, either of you, what's your favorite song that you get to sing in the show?
My favorite is a Reba song. It's Take It Back. Mm-hmm. Is my favorite one to do in this show. Although, mm-hmm. I have really started to like Cleopatra.
Mm. You do Queen of
really
Denial.
Well. Yeah, Queen of Denial. I really like that one.
I love watching you do that one. I know I do.
Because you get to eat candy,
yeah, I know.
And just sit there.
You betcha.
Good for you.
I also like Take It Back. That's one of my favorite songs in the show because all I sing is Take It Back. I think Heaven and Heartache,
uh-huh.
for sure.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that one's fun.
Very cool.
Yeah, I like that
Very
one.
Cool. Mm-hmm. We are now going to take another question from our audience at home. So let's take a look. Emily Tormey Dew. Question for Jessica and Emily. How is singing country music different than the traditional musical theater or other music that you've performed? What do you think? Deceptively hard, you said.
Yeah, I think it is, mostly because it's, well, so Emily and I, we know each other quite well now. I sing ballads more than I sing up-tempo stuff. Mm-hmm. So country music tends to be faster, and there's a lot more words. And so in a stage setting here, I have to articulate really hard. Otherwise, we miss what words are being said. So that is definitely different. Not articulation, but just the speed at which it goes. And the range tends to be quite a bit more broad than other types of genres. But this is how I sing, just not with a twang, usually, not with like an accent. But typically this is kind of the style that I would sing, just a little faster and a little, and with an accent and more diction.
Yeah. So, it is pretty rangy.
Tricky.
Your song, Stand By Your Man, sometimes it's hard, and then you...
Is that how I said it?
No.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh no!
You
oh
stand
dear!
By your
yeah,
man
that'll sell tickets. Great, Dan.
No, they're all rangy, and sometimes I'm
yeah.
like, "Hey, can we take this down a half step?" And I'm like, "Ooh, scraping the basement,
nope.
can't do that." And
went
I'm like,
too low.
It's just they are super rangy. I think that they're, you know, country singers, female country artists, first of all, get very little radio playtime compared to their male counterparts. Like, it's a huge deal, actually, and they just are hardcore singers. They sing from their, they just sing. And I, you know, you have to have a lot of respect for someone who does that, knowing that you're going to get like a quarter of the radio time.
Right.
That your male counterparts are going to get for doing kind of a regurgitated version of the last song that every other male country singer did, you know? And these women are like, churning their own stuff out, they're writing their own stuff, and it's, you know, hats off.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
It's just,
yeah, that's
they're
great.
Good. They're good.
That's great. Let's take a look at the video. We have a little
promo video.
A little promo video.
I was
what
like, oh
video
no. When was I in a video?
Of you two in the dressing room.
Oh, God.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Lana Mae's Honky Tonk Laundry. back to where I've been. Heaven, heartache, and the pain. Heaven, where I hope I'm going. Heartache.
Just a taste. That's what you look like.
Great.
Hey, thank you both. Thank you for coming in on your day off. Thank you for sharing your talents with us. And we look forward to seeing you tomorrow night, 7:30 curthan.
Thank you for that reminder. Thank you, guys.
Hey, so with that, we want to thank you all for joining us on this special Midday Cabaret cast edition. We want to thank Pearson Financial, of course, for all of their support. And we also want you to come see Honky Tonk Laundry. It's playing now through February 20th. You can call the box office, go to our website. But this is something you do not want to miss. So thanks for joining us, and I'll see you in the lobby.